Hello, children. Happy 2018. I've obviously taken a little hiatus. I've been a little busy. I have been traveling all over. I've been in California. I've been all over. First off, I'm broadcasting inside because it is January and it is freezing cold outside and there is not a lot to do out there in the snow. Secondly, I'm broadcasting from inside of a 300ZX. I went out and managed to get me a 92 300ZX and all my CN friends are like, why would you go and do a thing like that? Other than being a glutton for punishment, I'm just madly in love with these cars. I can't get over the way they look. I can't get over the way they drive. You know, ever since I was a kid, I'd wanted one of these. I remember pedaling to the roller rink I used to frequent as a kid and stopping and giving myself extra 15, 20 minutes just to stop at Ryker Nissan and gawk at the red two-seater they had there. That the lady who kind of helped raise me, Chris, if you're out there watching, Chris, Chris always had good tasting cars. She always had a Z car. She had a 280 and she had the 300 when it came out. I've always wanted one. It's not perfect. It's got its share of dings and dents in here and there. It definitely needs some love. It's a fairly original car. It wasn't perfect when I got it. It had like some crazy push button start on it because the owner didn't know how to fix the starter relay. That had a couple issues with it. So I got the car sorted through a couple small things, didn't dive too far into it. The clutch is kind of going out. And, you know, it generally just needs all around love. But the most important thing is the car is fairly stock and everything is there. I'm sure most of you know if you looked into buying these, it's not hard to get into something where it turns out to be a basket case. It drives like a sweetheart. It's really smooth. It's a great Gran Turismo. This is something you can drive across state in very comfortably and feel comfortable when you got there. So now that I've informed you guys about the car that I got, that also brings me to the second aspect is of this video is the content of this channel. Many of you know that I just make these videos out of just fun. I enjoy cars. I like editing videos. It's a lot of fun. I enjoy it. It is very time consuming. And so that has brought up the aspect of, do I want to make money off these videos? And I'm definitely considering that. I'm sure most of you that have peeked around my past content have found it to be pretty, it's pretty out there in some cases to be extreme, kind of maybe in some cases pushing the ballot of what's acceptable on YouTube. So that being said, I definitely have to change the content of this channel somewhat. Some other things too, which is I've got some other cars and some other stuff I have never shown. And, I'm definitely going to try and be better with, uploading some content to some of the other stuff I go and do with my time and other cars I get to engage with. And some more importantly, some of the great people I get to engage with, because a lot of the things I'm doing with these things I couldn't do by myself. I'm very fortunate to have a very few select group of people that, you know, help me with maybe their abilities or maybe just information and knowledge. This car definitely, I feel, is underpowered. We're definitely going to change some things here. I definitely going to change the appearance just because it needs some love. So until then, I appreciate you guys watching. I definitely appreciate the few that take the time to look at my little miserable channel and throw a like on there every now and then. It is greatly appreciated. Stay tuned and hopefully we'll have some new and interesting uploads here. So thank you so much for watching.